You may have noticed that developers sometimes say errors, sometimes they say mistakes, or bugs, or faults, or failures. And although these words all look the same, they do have small differences in their meaning. And in this video, that's what we're going to explore. Because in practice, having a common vocabulary can be really useful when it comes to communicating. So let's just start with failure. A failure is when a component or a software system behaves in a way that is not expected. So the final user was expecting the system to do something, but the system did something different. And a common example is when you have a blue screen. Instead of having the result you were expecting, you have this big crash. This is a failure. And a failure is usually caused by a defect. Some people call it bug or fault as well. They are all synonyms. And a bug is a flaw in a component or in any part of the software that causes the system to behave incorrectly. In other words, it's an incorrect statement that you have in your source code, like a greater than that should have been greater than or equals to, for example. So this is a bug. It is important to notice that maybe the bug exists in the source code, but it never becomes a failure. That can happen for different reasons. For example, that part of the system was actually never executed. So a bug only becomes a failure when it goes to the final user and it makes the system to behave incorrectly. A good example of a bug is the famous one on the Apple's SSL layer. If you pay attention to this code, you don't have to understand it, but there's a fairly small mistake in there. There are two go-to fail lines. This is definitely a bug, and this bug really caused a failure in many of the Apple systems. And finally, we have the error, or the mistake as we call it as well. And a mistake is about the human action that produces an incorrect result. And it can be that the human forgot to think about a specific corner case, and because of this, the person introduced the bug, and this bug later became a failure because the system behaved in an incorrect way. So a complete example can be, let's suppose you're in a train station and you then suddenly, when you look to the monitor, you see this big exception. The question is this a fault or a failure? What we should say is that we see a failure. The system failed to deliver what it was supposed to deliver. And this was caused by a fault or a bug in the source code. So these are some very important terms that I want you to know. And again, the importance of this is that now you have a common vocabulary to talk with other developers.